An aerial view of downtown Boston, our location tonight, gives you a great idea of the beauty of this historic city. Welcome, basketball fans, to a very special Veterans Day edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan, alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. David Aldridge joins us from the sideline. And now, a look at Boston's upcoming schedule. On Wednesday, they'll take on John Wall and the Washington Wizards. And then on Friday, they'll take on Steph Curry and the Golden State Warriors.
And for the matchup with the Suns, it's the second game of a back-to-back, and you know they're going to be feeling the effects of it. Playing that much basketball in that short amount of time really takes a toll.
And with pregame routines coming to an end, we're just about ready for our tip-off. First, though, let's get a report from the sideline and say hello to David Aldridge.
Well, last season, the Celtics tried to balance minutes between a talented core of younger players along with their trio of superstar veterans. With the departure of Kyrie Irving and Al Horford, now youth must be served. The question is, how far can that carry them?
And I feel, David, they're still in great position. I know you do, too. Thanks for that report. So let's take a look at the starters for the Dallas Mavericks. Kleba is the four with Porzingis in the middle. Doncic out there with Jalen Brunson. And it's Finney Smith in at the three. And for Boston, Brown and Hayward, they're the wings. Daniel Tice out there with Tatum. And it's Walker in at point guard. And the Celtics rebounding well this summer. From the loss of Kyrie Irving and Al Horford, Kemba Walker possibly a better fit for this team.
And with their young core, understandable that they didn't want to extend Horford out to age 37. A revamped roster, but I think they remain a contender in the East.
Now here's Brunson. And Hayward with the block. Tatum at the elbow. Porzingis with the block. Here's Finney Smith. Pass to Brunson. And he banks in the layup.
And it's always nice to get the easy look inside for your first points of the game.
And Walker kicks to Tice. Tatum on the wing. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Spurs in San Antonio. Just five to shoot. Mavericks with the rebound. Want to keep rolling here following the win against Memphis.
Yeah, those road games are tricky, but they had a good strategy going in and stuck to what they do best.
Yeah, you know, game balls all around in that one. A terrific team effort. They trusted in their system and executed well to get the win.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
Walker the pass to Hayward. Back to Walker. Tatum trying to break free. Walker's shot is off.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
And it's out of bounds. The Mavericks able to retain possession here. Fires from the corner. It's rebounded by Tice.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
And that one, good.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Now here's Porzingis. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Memphis.
And, of course, you cannot forget just how dominant his shot blocking was in that game. Just changed the entire complexion of that game.
The Celtics have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Hayward passes to Brown. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Well, Clark, no doubt you've been through this many times. A regular season is a grind. I think you said that before. Do the veteran players need to teach the young guys how to handle that schedule?
I clearly think, Kevin, that the veterans can be helpful, but there's nothing like firsthand experience. And you really have to experience the length and the grueling nature of the season to understand how you best can weather the schedule, but veterans certainly can be helpful.
Is there a rookie wall, Clark? Is that true?
Yeah, I think there is one. Clearly, I hit it, and most rookies that I've talked to during my time and beyond find a period in that season when they bump into that wall.
And Brown drops them both.
And the vertical that Brown has is quite impressive. As relentless a finisher that you'll find in this league.
Doncic outside. Here, the step back. He clangs that one off the back iron, and down it falls.
Watch out now. When this guy gets into a rhythm, it is something to behold.
And Walker kicks to Tice. Here's Tatum. Lays it up and banks it in.
Love when Tatum puts it on the floor now. Superb at driving right to the basket and has excellent speed to get there.
Brown against Doncic. And taken away by Brown. 5-on-3 break. Here's Walker. And trying for the go-ahead basket. It doesn't go in. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Brunson scanning the floor. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. It goes on Jason Tatum.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off and give him the layup. I mean, much better off making him go to the line.
And he makes the first.
And the Mavericks seem to have done the hard part, acquiring a potential franchise player in Luka Doncic.
And you know, guys, we've seen it, but in this league, one star isn't enough. That's why I think the trade for Porzingis was a good gamble. If he can stay healthy, they have an inside-outside star combo to build on.
Both good from the line that time.
Boy, you look at Maximilian Kleber, the German native. I mean, this guy is a very capable shooter, but it's his defense that keeps him on the court. He's 6'11", but has quick feet, which allows him to defend multiple positions.
Porzingis against Walker. Knocked loose, and it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way.
And so far, the story on Luka Doncic. Great showing for him last season. He was around 21 points per game last year, 8 rebounds, and 6 assists. And his playmaking really stands out, making his teammates better offensively with his terrific passing.
Yeah, he's outstanding at controlling the tempo. I mean, keeps the ball moving, and of course, finds the open man.
Now, here's Tatum, following the miss by Kemba Walker. Here's Brown. Porzingis with the block.
Boy, Porzingis doing a nice job staying in position and then using his reach to block shots.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Mark, you think of European players, it's usually the offensive end where they thrive, but Kleba is a versatile defensive stopper, too.
Yeah, I agree with you there. I mean, this guy can shut you down because he moves his feet, he's strong, really keeps driving lanes from opening up on the perimeter, and his positioning and timing make him a good shot blocker, too.
That free throw, no good.
You know, guys, the Dallas Mavericks with the longest active sellout streak of any pro basketball team. You can put sellout in quotes because they actually give a lot of tickets away to schools and community service groups to make sure that building is full.
Marcus Smart checked in for Tatum. So he can't get either to fall. You know, Clark, the Mavericks making their games accessible to Dallas fans, much more concerned with the packed house than the revenue at the gate.
Yeah, and I like that philosophy, guys. I mean, building their future fan base, those fans will be around for a while, giving young people a chance to become Mavericks fans for life. And you start early, and it pays dividends down the road usually.
And the Mavericks with possession here. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
Puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, G.A. He really does put pressure on you.
And you know, guys, showing how dynamic a weapon he is for this offense, they feed off of that energy and ability to make plays. It gets them going.
Now, here's Brown. 11 points for him in that last game against the Spurs in San Antonio.
And already, they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backboard.
And a trend they'd love to continue right through the next three quarters as well, Greg.
Austin with the ball, following the score by Dallas. Outside, Smart. Here's Walker. Sinks it from just inside the baseline.
Walker has such an excellent feel for the mid-range game, and he does a nice job recognizing when to shoot it from there.
Brunson finds Porzingis. Here's Doncic. No good on the triple.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
Here's Smart. That shot missing. Nice D from Porzingis. Passes it to Doncic. Here's Finney-Smith, guarded by Smart. Here's Porzingis, and the dunk by Porzingis.
Man, I like how close Porzingis gets to the rim. I mean, he knows when he's this deep, the defense really has no chance to keep him from dunking it.
Now here's Hayward. Outside, Smart. Porzingis with the rebound. Porzingis has got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Doncic outside. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Doncic has got his second bucket of the night.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
And here's Walker outside. It's rebounded by Porzingis. Porzingis has got six rebounds here tonight.
Boy, this is bad. Tough to watch. I mean, this is really bad. He's stone cold this quarter. Man.
Now, here's Smart. Walker the pass to Tice. Down low. And it's blocked.
They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game.
Yeah, sensational is a really good word for it, Greg. They're tearing it up on the glass.
Here's Kleba. Dallas moving the ball around. Here's Doncic. Misses off the left iron.
Boy, he knows he should have knocked that one down, especially with the defense not giving much of an effort.
And as a wing player, Haywood's just so good at attacking the basket. I think that's a big part of what makes him special. Doesn't take much of an opening for Hayward to make his move.
And Dallas calls their first time out of the game. And Clark, when you think back to your playing days in high school, what memories come to mind?
Well, just the fun of being able to have success all 4 years I was at St. Joseph High School in Cleveland, the way the city rallied around us my senior year when we had a chance to play for a state championship, unfortunately came up short. The teammates and coaches and teachers that I had a chance to enjoy those 4 years with, all really fond, special memories for me. Austin making some changes. Cantory checked in for Daniel Tice. Williams comes in for Gordon Hayward. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in for Walker. And the Mavericks will go for a different look here. Cauley-Stein, he's checked in for Porzingis. Ipao comes in for Maxi Kleba. Hardaway's checked in for Dorian Finney-Smith. And it's Seth Curry in for Jalen Brunson. Boy, like seeing these passes. Doncic has a keen sense for when one of his guys is open, and he gets it to him on time on target.
Wanamaker, the pass to Brown. Back to Wanamaker. Shot clock at 6. It's stolen by Curry. Here's Cauley-Stein, and Cauley-Stein throws it down.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
Now, here's Brown. Over Hardaway. Goes back up. Williams, good on the shot.
And that one gives them a +5 rebound advantage, Kevin.
Pretty clear. They're dominating that area. They've come out with a lot more energy and effort so far.
Here's Curry. Doncic outside. 1:10 left here in the opening quarter. Takes the 13-footer, and the Mavericks getting another bucket right there.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
Wanamaker, the pass to Williams. It's Brown on the wing. He sinks the 11-footer.
I like the confidence and the assurance that Brown is taking these shots with. I mean, his mid-range game is actually on point.
Pass to Doncic. Over Smart. And it's Doncic. That time on the assist by Curry. Doncic has got 8 points.
Oh, great ball movement there.
Here's Wanamaker. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Cantor kicks to Williams. There's the pass to Wanamaker. No good on the three. Dallas leading by 10. No one near Doncic as he lets it fly. And it's Dallas with another.
Nice pass here to set that basket up.
Seth Curry.
Here's Wanamaker. One second left, and again it's Boston converting.
How about that move? You'll see very few players able to pull off. Just sensational stuff.
It's been all about Luka Doncic for the Dallas Mavericks. He got into double digits for the quarter with 10 points total. We've got more in store for you right after this. Gordon Hayward reunited with his college coach, Brad Stevens. He said they go way back.
Our relationship started when I was in high school. He came to my morning workouts and really recruited me at Butler and was kind of the first guy that I think believed in me that I could make it to the next level.
And I'm sure, Greg, that relationship played a big role in Hayward deciding to join the Boston Celtics.
And not just a connection, but a respect. Hayward now a veteran in this league, while Stevens has moved into the conversation for one of the better young coaches in our league.
And glad to have you with us, folks. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. And a breakdown here, guys. The hustle stats for Dallas.
You know, they've done a great job of getting a hand up on shooters. Actually, have gotten a lot of blocks as well, solidifying that defensive effort.
And also, how about the fact defensively they're getting that backboard and getting out in transition, especially in this first half.
On the court for the Mavericks, Doncic and Hardaway at the 2 and the 3. Powell is out there with Cauley-Stein, and it's Curry in at the point. Guys, you talk about players coming in and with a huge impact. Jason Tatum showed he was more than ready to be an NBA star.
Where do you see a player as polished and as impactful as Tatum? Stepped right in to be one of the top players on a top team with Boston. Fits their system perfectly, and really the sky is the limit for that young man.
And that one falls for Tatum. Moves on moves. Greg, that's Jason Tatum.
I mean, this guy's a natural isolation scorer. Jab steps, crossovers, turnarounds, fadeaways. He's got an awful lot in his bag.
And the Celtics making a change here. Williams has checked in. And so Tatum nails them both. All right, Clark, game is on the line. One free throw to make to win a big game. Who is up there for you?
I'd go with your colleague and mine.
Oh, yeah.
But since he's no longer in uniform today, I will go with Steph Curry and Malcolm Brogdon.
Great names. Doncic finds Hardaway. Shot clock at 5. From deep three-point range. Rebounded by Smart. Celtics trail by 10. Dishes to Cantor. Smart trying to break free. And there's Cantor on the assist from Smart.
And we always talk about making your teammate better. That assist was right on target.
Pass to Conley Stein. Outside Hardaway. Knocks it loose. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Tatum.
And let's see the stat sheet here on Enes Kanter. A very nice season for him last year. 14th in rebounding. And he was in the top 20 in field goal percentage. Able to create offense with tremendous efficiency.
And we talked about how strong he was on the boards. Going hard at it at both ends last year. Really helping out his team. Now, here's Doncic. Picked up 33 points in their last win against the Grizzlies in Memphis.
And he also controlled the backboard as well. I mean, he really did a terrific job.
And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Celtics. Only given up 2 points this quarter. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. And that game is the second of two straight at home. Outside Curry. Let's a floater go. And it's out of bounds. The Mavericks able to retain possession here. That one's good. His second basket of 4, shooting 50%.
Nice body control by Seth Curry. I mean, he's so good at fending off defenders on the way up.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, if you were going to lose Kyrie Irving, why not replace him with Kemba Walker? The Celtics brought Walker in from Charlotte last offseason, and it looks like he's going to pay off big time in Boston. Celtics didn't exactly do what they wanted the last couple of years, but with Walker and Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum and a hopefully healthy Gordon Hayward, the Celtics aren't exactly going to be in the lottery anytime soon either.
Well, you're right on that, D.A. They're still stocked, and we love Walker. He'll, I think, mix well with this team. Thank you. Doncic finds Curry. Good. And the assist goes to Doncic. Curry's got 5 points now this quarter.
He's gaining more and more confidence over time from deep. Seth Curry proving he's got touch from out there.
Unloads. The shot misses. Now Boston takes it the other way. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with San Antonio.
Scoring efficiency was an issue in that one. Took them too many shots to get their points.
Yeah, and I think they just seem to be a page behind, a step slower out there all game.
Really crisp, intelligent passing to make that basket possible.
Passes to Doncic. And Boston with the rebound. And this matchup with Dallas, it's their first meeting of the season.
And it was a matchup you thought they would have cruised through, but they actually dropped a game in this series last year.
Greg, you know, it was 1-1 split from two teams on the opposite side of the standings. You know, as we've said many times, anything can happen when you play out of conference.
Now here's Curry. Some nice passing here by Dallas. Hardaway with it. He's coming off a 19-point game against Memphis. 4 on the clock. Fires from deep. No good. And the Celtics going the other way now. Tatum. And that one drops for him. Tatum's got 11 points. And the Mavericks call time here.
And team strategies closely guarded. One aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to.
Yeah, typically there's some type of adjustment made out of a timeout. It might be major, or it could be just a slight tweak.
Check real street from the setting check. I was in the projects, now I'm on the jet. I ain't even trying to talk, give it ain't about a check. Yeah, on that bands in my pocket, it's on me. Only people don't roll it. Lonely, it's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying wow. On that bands in my pocket, it's on me. Yeah, your grandma will probably know me. Lonely, it's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying wow.
And some changes here for the Celtics. Gordon Hayward comes in for Enes Kanter, and it's Kemba Walker in for Smart. And the Mavericks will go for a different look here. Porzingis is checked in for Cauley Stein. Maxi Kleba comes in for Dwight Powell. Dorian Finney-Smith's checked in for Hardaway. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Luka Doncic. And the Celtics with possession here, following the three-point basket by Dallas. Williams passes to Walker. To answer back, but that three is off the mark.
And they continue to control the glass.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
Kleba kicks to Finney-Smith. Back to Kleba. Curry with a wide open look. Another three for Dallas.
The defense a step slow, and you can see the result.
Greg, that's three in a row from out there now, so they've got to do a better job contesting.
Now here's Williams. No points in the game yet for him. Back to Walker. Over Brunson. And the shot is good. The Maverick lead has been cut down now to just 10 points with that basket from Kemba Walker.
That jumper is pure as white snow. Walker's always had the talent. Now you can see the consistent mechanics.
Pass to Brunson. From past the arc, another three for Dallas.
That's a dozen straight points coming off the triple.
Yeah, Greg, you know, they're having free reign from beyond the arc. The defense is just not there.
And slam dunk by Tatum.
Tatum puts himself in really good position with his footwork. Fundamentally sound, he's on fire right now.
Well, one of the bigger names in free agency this past summer was Kemba Walker. A lot of teams, Greg, looking at him.
And rightfully so, Kevin. With Kemba, a point guard who is in his prime, he's an impact player who can hit big shots and is one of the more underrated stars in our league.
And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
Well, you have to give credit to Kemba Walker, who has always found ways to improve his game year after year. Has worked on that shot and tool set enough where he can now be a handful to defend for any guard.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw good from Walker. And with Walker, as he has progressed as a player, you know, Greg, so has his leadership.
And Kemba has been a natural leader for so long during his time. When your leader puts in the work that Kemba does, it has to inspire the rest of that roster.
Here's what Boston's going with right now. Daniel Tice is checked in for Robert Williams. Williams comes in for Jason Tatum. And it's Brown in for Brad Wanamaker.
Free throw shooting is about mechanics, confidence, and your mental approach. He's locked in from there most every night.
Brunson with it, working on Walker. Porzingis can't hit. Celtics trail by 11. Here's Brown. The shot's good on the assist by Walker. And it's 6 points for Jaylen Brown.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Brunson, no good. And here's Brown. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. Here's Hayward. Klaus Kontak on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
Boy, Brown, not just a super athlete, folks, Seth but Curry. He's got excellent skills as well. A tremendous floor general.
You talk about players that have transformed their bodies in the NBA.
Gordon
How about Gordon Hayward? Has added muscle every year while maintaining that speed and agility.
Free throw good from Hayward. You know, Greg, when he came into the league, Hayward looked so young. You almost don't recognize him now.
I mean, the suit of armor from his time in the weight room and the hair looking sharp to match.
And Finney Smith gets it to go.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
And, Greg, it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
Now, here's Tice. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Here's Brown, and another basket for Boston.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Well, the defensive rotations, Greg, have been a step slow, and it's really helped them get that ball inside time after time.
Here's Finney Smith. Following the basket by Jaylen Brown. Porzingis against Williams. Tries from 10. Sinks it. And the shot from Porzingis.
Boy, that is grown man ammonia strength from Porzingis there. How can defenders stop that?
Outside, Walker. 1:12 left in the second quarter. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
2 points.
Hawkers got 8 points.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Porzingis can't hit.
And one thing I liked in the first quarter was their aggressiveness to draw the contact, putting the defense on the defensive.
Yeah, exactly. And I think they need to continue to press that advantage. They've got to get back to that. Don't go away from that. It's been working so well for them. Stay with them.
Celtics have made the most out of their opportunities at the line. They have yet to miss in seven attempts.
And when you look at their numbers from a season ago, 80% as a unit,
take a break.
That's something
take
you'll
a break.
Be happy with.
Two shots.
The first one falls.
And, you know, there's no question about it. Hayward is an exciting player and an athletic forward who can really, really score.
Hayward hits them both. There's 47 seconds left in the first half. Brown against Curry. Rebound, Boston. Tice has got his seventh rebound here tonight. Guys, this offense very effective.
And guys, the defense has been no match. They've just picked them apart.
Shot is good, and the Mavericks lead is cut down now to just three in the basket from Williams.
That was big because they dug a big hole in the first quarter, but starting to show signs of life.
Sometimes, for whatever reason, a lot of times you don't know why, it takes a little while to work the knots out, but it looks like they're putting it together right now. And he can take over in a nanosecond. I mean, once he catches fire, it's difficult to squelch it.
And so it's the Dallas Mavericks with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. They're pounding the ball inside, and that's where they've gotten their best production tonight. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is right here. Say hey to the folks, Kenny.
Hey, folks.
Say hey to the folks, Shaq.
Hey, folks.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Okay.
From the get-go, it was Dallas that came out strong. They led by as many as 12 points, fueled by tough defense and great offense. After a solid quarter of play, they held a 10-point lead. The second quarter wasn't as kind to them, but they still fought through some mistakes to have a 6-point cushion at the half. And Kenny, what are your thoughts on how Dallas played?
Well, there was a big spark from the bench in the first half. Sometimes you're hoping for your reserve to come in and just hold court, but they didn't do that. They actually got better.
And Shaq, your thoughts on the Celtics?
There's no excuse for letting a team drain that many threes. Come on, especially at such a high percentage. That means your perimeter defense is weak. They gotta close out on the shooters with conviction, even if it creates some weakness inside.
Thanks for joining us, folks. We're now just a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter.
We got the soldiers when and in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. Now, here's Walker. Hayward at small forward with Tatum at the four. Walker and Brown, they're manning the backcourt. And it's Tice in at the five. That's the Boston five.
Tatum showing you his force that time, being athletic and aggressive on the finish.
And here's Brunson. The pass to Doncic. And it's blocked. And it's out of bounds. The Mavericks able to retain possession here. Six on the shot clock. Right side, Porzingis. Count it. Porzingis has got six. Celtics trail by six. Walker surveying the floor. Hayward outside. And the shot goes down. He's got 11. Mark, I have sat next to you doing these games for years. What's prevented you from taking a coaching position at some level? Because I hear you talk, I'm thinking you'd be a perfect coach.
Well, a couple of things. One, coaching never lets up. It's always on you. And I've come to enjoy the fact that I can be fully immersed as a broadcaster and work with great guys like you and others, and then have a period of time where I don't have to be immersed in basketball. And I've enjoyed that. And I also haven't trained or prepared to be a coach because it is demanding in terms of the hours that you have to put in. And I've got a little more job security, I think, in the role that I serve as an analyst as opposed to what might happen if I did try to be a coach.
You've got all the security in the world, believe me.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, there is a lot of optimism in Dallas for the tandem of Luka Doncic and Kristaps Porzingis. Porzingis said, "We clicked right away. We're both European players, similar roots, both speak Spanish. That'll translate on the court. We can be something special." Kevin, look out for them to compliment and criticize one another in a different tongue.
If they play to their potential, they could be scary. Thanks, David. Now Porzingis. After Gordon Hayward's three-pointer, they didn't go. Five to shoot. And a bit of a battle here for the ball. The official signals a jump ball here. And it's the Mavericks with the ball. Finney-Smith passes to Porzingis. Some nice passing here by Dallas. And Doncic, here we go. And he gets it to go. Doncic has got 14 points.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
Here's Walker. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
That's insane. Boy, you look at how tall Porzingis is. He's 7'3", and you add in his skill level,
Kemba,
that's a unique combination. No wonder they call him the unicorn. He is unique.
And he knocks down the first one. And Clark, the advantage of height, well known in basketball, but some have wondered if Porzingis is almost too tall.
Well, you know, there's a concern because he's had a significant injury early in his career, and his frame is really long, which makes you a little more susceptible to injuries. But I think KP has worked diligently to add strength and improve his body. Only time will tell if he's able to stand up to a long, productive NBA career.
Now here's Brunson. 19 points in the game. Hardaway against Brown. Hardaway passes to Cauley-Stein. That's tipped, and he's able to get it back.
Celtics.
And Kemba Walker is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul. And some changes here for the Celtics. Robert Williams, he's checked in for Jaylen Brown. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in for Walker. Third quarter of basketball here in just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by. And Cauley-Stein has it in the corner. Off target with his three.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Tatum and foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's on Luka Doncic.
Yeah, I like the aggressiveness of Jason Tatum there. He's looking for contact and doing a nice job drawing the fouls there.
And this is his second trip to the line in the game. And that one falls for Tatum.
During his rookie season, Jason Tatum was Boston's go-to guy in the Eastern Conference Finals. A rare opportunity, and that young fella delivered at a high level.
And so Tatum nails them both. In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Now here's Brunson. He's guarded close. Outside Hardaway. Sinks the triple.
Hardaway
has got himself on the board with three there.
Three.
Boy, that quick trigger mindset. When Hardaway Jr. is firing away like this, you know he's feeling it.
Here's Williams. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Smart misses. Doncic feeling it out. Hardaway with a wide open look. And the wing jumper offline. Celtics trail by six. Here's Wanamaker. Pass to Tatum. Cantor with it. Passes it to Wanamaker. Just five on the clock. And he's good on the three ball. Wanamaker's got his second bucket of the night.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
Well, I'm going to credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays there.
Now here is Hardaway. And Doncic gets it to go.
Boy, Doncic showing you his competitiveness right there with the back at you three. The revenge triple.
Wanamaker the pass to Cantor. Over Cauley-Stein. Shot is good, and the Mavericks lead is cut down now to just 4 points with the basket from Cantor.
And when he rises up, he knows he's probably going to get a clean look. It's a matter of executing.
You know, for me, it doesn't get any better than seeing big fellas who can use the mid-range jumper to their advantage.
Well, the number 33 pick in the 2018 draft, Jalen Brunson, off to a pretty good start.
Boy, I tell you what, this guy is so solid. He was the Naismith Player of the Year and a two-time champion at Villanova. No surprise to see him handling his business in the pros because he's all business.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He's off on the first. And he's good on the second. Here's Wanamaker. He's got five. Pass to Cantor. The shot, no good. And the Mavericks going the other way now. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. Next up for them, the Knicks, a road game in New York. It'll be the third game of this three-game road trip.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Boy, it's been a three-point barrage. They came out gunning and have not stopped.
Now, here's Cantor. And the pass to Wanamaker. Now, here's Tatum. Powell pulls it in.
Solid rebound there, and with the score like it is, that's an area where they can't afford to get lazy.
Yeah, another column in the stat sheet that hasn't gone in their favor. To climb back, they've got to put forth more effort.
And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Tatum. Austin making a switch here. Williams has checked in. Curry's checked in for Dallas. Here's Hardaway, six to shoot. That one rolling around and rims out.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding him.
And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
That's his first.
These are the players who had the most success from deep last season. Look at Curry, third in the NBA. He's someone that, if you leave him alone, he's going to knock it down.
The bucket must have looked 3 feet wide to him last year. I mean, very deserving in terms of that spot among the league leaders from three.
First one falls for him.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
Yeah, you know what? And I think they've just got to keep on keeping on. Keep drawing contact, attacking, getting to the line. That will certainly give them a chance to get back into the game.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws. Mavericks leading by six. Pass to Doncic. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Curry's got four assists in the game.
Well, you look at Doncic, so confident, even from this area. He knows he can make it happen.
On the wing, Williams. Pass to Wanamaker. The Celtics working the ball around now. Smart deciding where to go with it. To the middle. Lock at six. The basket counts and one. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it a three-point play.
Tell you what, that's impressive strength there from Tatum. You got to respect that. Even when you try to wrap him up, he finds a way to score.
At the line.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for Dallas.
Well, I got to say, one thing that stuck out all game is the consistent penetration they've got.
Couple that with just how well they've shot it from beyond, and they've made this thing look easy.
Tatum no good on the free throw.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound department, but that oftentimes is all it takes.
Especially, Greg, when you're scoring the ball at a decent clip the way they have. I mean, they've done exactly what's necessary to take the lead.
Oh, and when you see that step back three, Clark, for Doncic, shades of James Harden the way he gets that shot off.
And you know what? They say Luka's deceleration, hitting the brakes and stopping suddenly, is top-notch, just like James Harden's. So that's quite a compliment. A lot of that is footwork and balance, but I think his quickness too, guys, has been a little bit underrated. This guy is a little better athlete than he gets credit for.
That free throw good from Doncic.
Well, you look at Luka Doncic, and the one skepticism scouts had was his athleticism or lack thereof. And I think he's proven that's not necessary to be a great basketball player. And he's only getting better as he works with NBA trainers.
Boy, they've been terrific from beyond here in the second.
Exactly what the doctor ordered. Those three-point bombs will erase the deficit quickly if they can keep it up.
Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher, and coach knows it.
Showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. They're going to ride him as far as he can take him.
Now, here's Cantor. Here's Walker. Banked in off the glass. Walker's got 4 points in the quarter. And you know, you heard about Doncic. Even if he's a step slow, he's always two steps ahead with his mental game.
You know, Kevin, that's a great, great point. Feel, savvy, experience, know-how. You know, he grew up playing against bigger, stronger guys, and that always serves you well as you go forward. So he understands how to create space and anticipate and feel how to get defenders off balance. I mean, he's just a special, special young player.
Now Walker, after Luka Doncic's three-pointer that didn't go. Tatum, that falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. Now just a four-point Maverick lead. Dallas calls timeout. Well, the book, Greg, is the same for Enes Kanter as it's always been. Great score inside, but his defense leaves you wanting.
And Kevin, at this point, he is who he is. I mean, for better or worse. Kanter is still a force off the bench to give a team some post presence in their second unit, but not sure he'll ever be a player to build around.
Some changes for Boston. Daniel Tice is checked in for Kanter. Hayward comes in for Williams. And it's Brown in for Marcus Smart. Porzingis, he's checked in for the Mavericks. Now, here's Doncic. 24 points for him. We've got 1:18 left in the third. Now, Hardaway. Curry outside. Hits it from three-point range. Curry's got 13.
Well, you know, guys, we know Hardaway can score, but when he makes these passes, it makes him a lot more dangerous.
It's good.
And not relying at all on the three-point shot. They may want to rethink about stretching the defense a bit like they did in that first half.
Now, here's Curry. 13 points in the game. The 11-footer. And Boston with the rebound. Tice has got his 8th rebound here tonight. Ahead. And the shot is good. The Maverick lead has been cut to just 3 points on the basket from Gordon Hayward.
Good read from Tatum that time. Saw the defense had overcommitted and then made them pay with the sweet dime. Well done.
Now, here's Doncic. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
That's his first personal foul.
He's gone 1 of 1 in the game so far from the line.
And he finished last season right around 71% from the line, so not exactly his best percentage.
And, you know, with those numbers, he makes a defender hesitant to get too tight on him. I mean, he doesn't want to get whistled for the foul and put this guy on the line.
Two shots.
The first free throw is good.
There's an awful lot to like about Doncic, but probably what jumps out at me most is how competitive he is. I mean, he wants to dominate whoever's guarding him.
Looking at who's out there now for the Mavericks. Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Powell. And Dorian Finney-Smith subbed in for Hardaway. All free throws good from Doncic.
And done a much better job from the line this half. They've gotten that percentage up over 80 for the game.
Shot and game clock separated by 5. Curry against Walker. Pass to Tatum from deep. The shot's good on the assist by Walker. Walker's got 6 assists here tonight.
You know, he's got to be exasperated right now, fellas. I mean, playing excellent ball, but they're still losing.
Here's Porzingis. Dallas, no good that time either. And as we conclude the third quarter, what a game. Neither team giving ground. Mavericks lead by 2. And we'll have the start of the fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, a terrific, unselfish play right here. Set up his teammate, and how about the setup this was?
Yeah, and as a two guard, he's typically not a reluctant shooter, so it was really nice to see him orchestrating for a teammate instead.
We did it. And with these teams locked in a very close contest, this fourth quarter promises to be a good one. On the floor for Dallas, Curry and Doncic, the guard pair. Kleba is the 4 with Porzingis in the middle. And it's Finney-Smith in at the 3, the small forward. Here's Finney-Smith. And it's out of bounds. The Mavericks able to retain possession here. So it's the Mavericks now. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game.
Can't be too aggressive when guarding Seth Curry because he's good at attacking and drawing fouls.
Seth Curry. 2 shots.
Shooting 2.
And the first one at the line is good.
And just like his brother Steph, Seth is an impressive bucket getter. I mean, somebody whose role is to shoot and score the ball.
And both free throws good for Curry. Celtics trail by 4. Walker in the post. Curry meets him. And they'll keep possession. Here's Tatum. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Tatum's got 29 in the game.
Tatum's got a nice jump shot. When he's in rhythm, you feel like he's going to make it every time he shoots.
Curry kicks to Porzingis. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Curry's got his 6th assist on the night. Brown against Doncic. Brown drives in and finished off by Brown.
Just awesome speed from Brown. Blasting off towards the bucket and slamming it down.
Brown's gotten four of his seven shots to go. To the inside, Doncic. And the dunk by Doncic.
Those plays can make a difference in a game like this.
Well, you know it's going to fire up, Greg, everybody on that bench.
Making a statement for sure. I mean, we'll see if they can maintain that aggressive approach, guys.
Shot's good by Walker.
Well, I tell you what, in these sets, it's hard to know how to guard Kemba Walker. Quick, crafty, and lethal with that shot. So good at taking what's in front of it.
Outside, Porzingis. Gordon Hayward comes up with the rebound. The Celtics have gone 3-of-4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. And they take the lead. Brown's got the lead up to 1 now for Boston.
You know, the three-point shot, guys, is something that Brown continues to improve upon. It's important for him to be knocking down these looks to expand his offensive repertoire.
Now, here's Doncic, and the dunk by Doncic.
The finish was nice, but the setup was better.
Yeah, G.A., the pick working to full effect before the stuff.
And, you know, not enough help from the defense there to compensate. He gets a clean look, and that's exactly how you draw it up.
Here's Walker, following the score by Dallas. That one goes in.
How about these big shots for him in the fourth? He has been locked and loaded offensively.
Outside, Porzingis. Here's Curry. That one falls through. It's his sixth make from the floor this game. Now 6-for-10.
Boy, KP wanting to dish it when his guys are open. I love that team-first attitude on display.
And Walker kicks to Brown. Nice ball movement by Boston. Finished off by Brown.
And Brown is quite aggressive. I mean, a masterful penetrator who can take it to defenders when he drives.
Here's Finney-Smith. A pass to Porzingis. To the paint. Here's Curry. Rejected by Walker. Brown against Doncic. Hayward. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
2 points.
Brown's got his fourth assist in this one. And, guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for the Celtics?
You know, block shots, guys, a clear indicator on the stat sheet of their excellent defense. I mean, leaving them no room to get off any shot.
And also, how about the points they've gotten in transition or on the fast break tonight? That's been a huge factor as well.
And it's blocked. Guys, we've seen some excellent offensive output.
Yeah, great momentum for them offensively.
You know, that's exactly what you want from your point guard. Get the ball to the open guy on time and on target.
Now here's Porzingis. Here's Finney-Smith. It's stolen by Brown. And a fast break now for the Celtics. Here's Tatum. Nice D from Porzingis. Mavericks trail by 5. Down low. And Curry the bucket on the assist by Doncic. Curry's got 9 points here in the second half. And so it's Walker with it who brings it up for the Celtics. Well, time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
Break away, make away, make love the way you look it.
Don't you?
Johnson. He's checked in for Curry. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Brad Stevens had to say to his team. He wants them to maintain their balanced attack, but he told them they're doing a great job of finding space out on the perimeter, which has led to all those good shots. He likes the rhythm and the flow of this offense. He just told them, keep shooting it with confidence. Kevin?
Boy, for a young player, it's so good to see Doncic make an effort on both ends like we saw there.
Here's Brown. It's rebounded by Doncic. Doncic has got 4 rebounds now tonight. And he makes good on the layup. Doncic has got 34.
Doncic is able to blow by opponents and make them pay. Even though he's not the greatest athlete, he's sneaky quick.
And it's Walker penetrating. Here's Tice. Nice work on the board. He's paying off with the basket.
It's been a tight one so far. Very close game.
And matchups, it's really what it's all about, and these two teams are really equal.
Now, here's Doncic. Porzingis finds Doncic. Here's Kleba. Now, here's Brunson. 5 on the clock. Outside, Porzingis. Another 3 for Dallas.
Yeah, the first half was one to deep 6 or forget, but in the second half, he's looked a lot better.
Outside, Walker. It's Brown with the drive and foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
That's insane. You know, Brown really forcing the issue there on the drive, making sure that he drew contact.
Shooting for Boston. Jaylen Brown will be at the line shooting 2.
Free throw good from Brown. He hits both from the stripe. And here is Doncic. Pass to Finney-Smith. Dallas moving the ball around. Another 3 for Dallas.
And memo to the rest of the team, continue to get him the basketball. He's clearly delivering here in the 4th.
Yes, sir. He is dialed in. 6 of 6 in the quarter. Dallas is looking for more.
And year 3, the best of Dorian Finney-Smith's career.
Yeah, you know, he upped his scoring rate, guys, and rebounding. He became more efficient and undrafted out of college, played his college ball at Florida, and he's made himself a nice home in the NBA.
And the first one drops.
Tell you what, Walker is an exceptional scorer. I mean, a clever guard who wreaks havoc with his quickness and ball skills.
And so Walker nails both of them. And so it's Brunson with it. He brings it up for Dallas. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. Passes it to Finney-Smith. And here's Brunson. Defended by Hayward. 6 on the shot clock. They get the rebound. Here's Porzingis. Tries yet again. No luck. They battled on the glass but couldn't knock it down. Boston trailing. And it's Walker penetrating. It's good. That's 8 baskets for him now. 8 for 15 shooting.
Walker demanding the ball when they need a bucket, relishing these moments.
And Brunson has it in the corner. Back to Doncic. Hayward comes with the double team. And stolen by Hayward. And they cash in right away with the quick shot. And now it's a three-point Celtic lead.
He's so clutch, Kevin. When the pressure is at its highest, that's when he's at his very best.
Brunson, good.
You love how each side has risen to the challenge throughout this one.
Hey, defense has taken a back burner, secondary on the marquee, but who doesn't love a game like this? Let's go. I like offense.
Now, Doncic, following the miss by Kemba Walker from deep. Porzingis, and the dunk by Porzingis.
Knowing his team needs a hoop, Porzingis says, I'll get it done.
Inside, here's Tatum, and slam dunk by Tatum.
And Tatum, Kevin, has been in these situations before. He's reliable when it comes to stepping up in big moments.
Now, here's Brunson. Out to the right wing. Shot from 16, and the Mavericks getting another bucket right there. And guys, here in the fourth quarter, still a close game.
Instant classic, fellas. This one could come right down to the last shot.
Here's Walker. Over in the corner, Brown. Pass to Tice. And there's the second dunk to finish it off.
Big time basket there on the inside. I mean, he had to get that one up and over the big guy.
Way up and over the big guy. And what a time in the ball game to make it happen.
Now here's Brunson. Here's Porzingis. Tries again. Doncic trying to get open. Count it.
Oh, you just love seeing a player with absolutely no fear.
Cool, calm, collected, and confident in the biggest moment of the game? Yes.
Walker with it. Brunson covering. It's in!
And, you know, Walker makes a quick decision with the ball there. Good to see him making a solid pass like that.
And the Mavericks call time here. They're trailing by one. 50 seconds left here in the fourth quarter.
The Celtics Dancers!
And our Jordan player of the game, Jason Tatum.
And his performance has been a jaw dropper. He must have been feeling great coming into the building tonight, because once he hit the court, it was all working for him. He was in a zone.
Seconds left in the fourth quarter. Now here's Brunson. He's covered by Brown. Outside, Porzingis. It's good!
But you know what, guys? You want the ball in Porzingis' hands in clutch moments. Why? He's an impact player.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. They trail by one. 34 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
And usually you want to go for the 2-for-1 here to maximize the clock.
We'll be right back. Here's Walker. Now the pass to Tatum. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And Tatum does a little bit of everything, and he's especially skilled down low. Fantastic at drawing the defense into him and playing off the contact while he's going up for a shot.
At the line, the Celtics. Jason Tatum. You give him on the shooting two.
He hits the first one, and that ties the game up. And so both free throws good that time, and that puts him ahead.
And he doesn't let the pressure get to him. Cool and confident from the line.
6 second difference between shot and game clock. Dallas calls timeout. They're down by one. 27 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Wow. All right, fans, get on your feet and make some noise for T-shirt time. Real street, full of sitting check. I was in the projects, now I'm on the jet. I ain't even trying to talk, if it ain't about a check. Yeah, but if there's a one pocket, it's on me. Only people that are rolling. Lonely, it's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying why.
Porzingis, not a lot of room. To the middle. Here's Kleba. Money!
And they do have a foul to give.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. They're trailing by one. There's 18 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
The craziest fans get a free t-shirt. Let's hear it, fans!
She said, don't be stressing in the limelight. Then get your mind right. Ayy, prayers up for the most part. Ain't no killing on the sofa. Head gone, head so far. In the clouds, any minute now, I should get it now, already told ya. I've been tired of the useless. I've been tired of the using. I ain't even taking it loosely. No, don't move me. Thinking it's a movie. I just wanna make a movie. Niggas like that when it just needs.
With it. Count it!
There isn't anybody they trust more than Walker down the stretch. He's made so many big shots over the course of his career. Add another one to the list.
And so it's Boston sweeping by with the win. That was a fun night of basketball and fabulous finish as they continued to wait out until the very last moment to seal it.
And there are so many times when you see these tight games won at home, that advantage of having that crowd behind you oftentimes is the ultimate X factor.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Gordon, what turned this game around tonight?
Came out with energy in the second half. I mean, after we had a little bit of a lull there, called a timeout, and we regrouped and got it together. I thought we played well, shared the basketball. We regrouped.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a different team the second half. Thanks, Gordon. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA on 2K Sports. So long.